Our life is completely surrounded everywhere by the plastics. The result of this is that whenever we go anywhere outside, we see a lot of waste of plastic, and we are completely surrounded by the waste of all these plastics. But do you think that these plastics are causing harm only to the other species, I mean the fishes and the birds? No, they are basically harming us also. They are affecting our reproductive system, they are making us infertile, they are creating a lot of health problems to us, and in fact they are carcinogenic also, means that they are making us prone for the cancers. I'm Dr. Akansha, consultant obstetric and gynecology and endoscopic surgeon. Today in this video we'll be dealing that how this plastic usage are making us infertile. As we all know that the rate of infertility is increasing day by day. In fact, the rate of male infertility is increasing on a greater pace. Now, let's look at small data. The average sperm count in 1970s was 99 million per ml. And the average sperm count, if we look in the last 4-5 years, is just 47 million per ml. Means it has reduced to almost 50%. So what can we do to prevent ourselves, to prevent our fertility, in fact to prevent human extinction? See, what happens is whenever these plastics are molded to form any shape or to make any atom, various chemicals are used. The most common chemicals which are used are phthalates and BPA and BPS. About BPA you must have heard, because now many of the products come with the label of BPA free products. Now what happens is these phthalates and BPAs and BPS, what they do is they mimic the estrogen and testosterone, means estrogen in the female body and testosterone in the male body. And when we ingest them, our body is in the false perception that it has enough estrogen and testosterone, but in actual it does not have. And in this way, it is basically dysregulating our endocrine system, our reproductive system. And not only this, these BPA, these phthalates are basically causing direct harm on the sperm concentration, sperm quality. They are increasing the oxidative stress and inflammation in the sperms. They are decreasing our ovarian reserve, that is the number of eggs which we have in our body is getting decreased day by day because of the exposure of this BPA and phthalates. And not only this, the rate of miscarriage, means the number of people who are conceiving also, the risk of miscarriage is more in those who are exposed to these chemicals. And various birth defects are found because of these chemicals. It has been shown in various researches in the recent past few years that risk of Down syndrome is increasing because of this, because of these chemicals. So now, what to do to prevent this? We just need to be aware that where are these chemicals used and how to avoid their usage. See, phthalates, which I talked about, these are basically used to make the plastic flexible and give them strength. So they are used in various food containers, water bottles and various plastic bags and toys. And this BPA is used to make the plastic harder, and so it's used in various plastic products. Another property of BPA is that it prevents corrosion, and that's why it is used to line the various cans. So the can products are also basically increasing our risk for this BPA exposure. And this BPA has another property also, that it gives a glossy appearance, and so it is present in various
sale receipts
which we get in the malls or any other shop whenever we go for the shopping. So now what to do? See, we cannot completely avoid using this plastic, although if we willfully want we can do it, but obviously that will take time. So at least avoid usage of these plastic in any form of drinking or eating, so that we do not get a direct exposure of these chemicals in our body. So because what happens that when we heat any of these products, either in the form of lunch boxes, or we heat a cling wrapped food or plastic wrapped food in the microwave, these chemicals basically get dissolved. When we ingest that food, we get exposed to these chemicals. So now what can we do to prevent all this? Minimize the various canned, pre-packaged, processed and foods which are wrapped in the plastic or have a cling wrap over them. If you want to heat your food in a microwave, avoid using a plastic container, use a glass bowl for that.
Avoid keeping all these sale receipts in your wallet,
because as I have told that they have a BPA covering over that. Keep steel or glass bottle with you. Try to avoid various plastic water bottles. In fact, try to avoid disposable cups also. And it's a very common culture in the IT companies to drink coffee or tea in the disposable cups. But we never know that these disposable cups are also lined by a very thin line of plastics. When this plastic comes in exposure to the hot water which we use to make the coffee, this plastic basically disintegrates into microplastics, and we ingest that microplastic. According to a recent research, it was seen that if we drink 3 cups of coffee in these disposable cups in a day, we are ingesting 75,000 of microparticles of these microplastics.
When all these discussion was going on, some people came for the argument that we use BPA free product. Yes, you might be using BPA free product, but do you know the product which you are using as a BPA free product do not contain phthalates or other chemicals like BPAs? You never know, and in fact it's not written anywhere. So better is to avoid them.
So friends, as I have told that obviously it will take time to avoid all the plastic material from our life, but at least try to avoid plastic for your drinking and eating purposes. Okay friends, I think you must have understood that how these plastics are making us infertile and how to avoid them, how to prevent them. If you like this video, do like, share and subscribe this channel, and please share with other couples also who are planning their pregnancy or if they are pregnant, so that they can have a safe conception and a safe motherhood. You can follow me on the Facebook also for various other posts and videos. Okay, take care, bye.